Today, I'm going to share four things that I am getting from not twisting my hair for the last 4 months. So the first thing is that I'm giving my hair a chance to breathe. So the initial reasoning was that I wanted to start to really spend some time just letting my hair grow as well as breathe from all of the twisting and pressure that I may put on it. And then what I realized is that what I started to do more often than not was my hair had become this thing about styling it and doing hairstyles and all those things more than nourishing and taking care of it. So the first reason that I did it was one, I wanted to just take a break. And so I'm getting the break that I need. So that's the first thing. The second thing that I'm getting out of it that was unexpected was that I'm getting confidence in myself and my ability to see myself as beautiful, regardless of if my hair is twisted or not. And so that seems so simple because I'm always confident in some sense about my hair and my being. However, I do twist my hair a lot. I do style it. I do try to make sure that I do different things with it. But what I'm learning in this journey of not twisting until 40 is that my hair is getting healthier, but I'm also seeing myself as beautiful, regardless of if it's styled or twisted. So one, my hair is getting healthy from just breathing. Two, I am actually starting to be more confident and expressive about loving myself without having to be a twist or the perfect look. And then three, and I said I was going to do four, the last one's going to be really quick. It's kind of going to be in conjunction with three, is not only am I getting the rest I need, not only am I getting to see myself as fully beautiful, regardless of if it's perfected or not, but I'm also getting an opportunity to reconnect with my original reason for growing my hair, which was my commitment to my identity and self. And so I am coming up literally in the next few weeks on 19 years of having my hair locked. And one of the things that this journey has taught me is that through the ups and downs, through the journey of being natural, and also know now where the world is as it relates to being natural, it's actually a pleasure to experience and participate in a community that was not existing when I started in terms of locking my hair, and now has blossomed into this movement and love fest that is awesome. And so I'm actually thinking one of the things that I got from this is that I love this experience and this journey from being isolated somewhat in terms of the community and it being seen as something that was not so great, to moving to a place of acceptance as a people and as a woman, as women, where our hair is an expression of ourselves, but we can do it in a way that is naturally who we are and who God created us to be on this earth. So three and four kind of go together. I learned that I actually appreciate the journey. And I also learned that the original portion of this journey was just as valuable in terms of nurturing and acknowledging that you can do something alone, but it's actually okay also to celebrate when you see an acceptance and a tribe of women embracing their inner beauty and self beauty. And so what I got from non-twisting over these last 4 months seems so silly, but are very huge things for me, which is, you know, I just got the rest I needed. Your hair needs rest sometimes. I'm the confidence to look good and be good with myself, regardless of if my hair is twisted and perfect, quote unquote. And then two or three and four, which is the journey, and then the tribe and community that comes with the journey of loving yourself and loving who you were made to be, naturally you. All right, you guys be well.